The Secretary has said, today we are not here for blame shifting or to fight anyone. Today we are here as Kenya Union of Clinic Officers to start a national conversation, because we say that health is so much important that you cannot leave it to any particular individual or institution. It must be a concern of every Kenyan, because in the Constitution of Kenya, Article 43, we give ourselves as the citizens the right to the highest attainable standard of healthcare. Having said that, I think anytime you go into a battle, anytime you have challenges, you must come out and have a post-mortem and look at what went wrong, what were the weaknesses, what were the strengths, and then when you get your weaknesses, you get the opportunities to make it even better. And that is what we are calling for today, because it's a conversation we are starting, that we are hoping that 2022 will be the turning point where we can be able to have a paradigm shift in the health sector to make the health system so strong and resilient that we will not have to suffer the same under the same challenge if and when it comes again. Because we know at some point, no matter how many years are to come, we are going to have a similar challenge. There are things that we have identified. Even before the corona pandemic itself, our children under 5 were still dying of diarrhea and vomiting. They were still dying of malaria. They were still dying of pneumonia and other diseases, diseases that can actually be avoided. And why have they been dying? It is because we have a critical shortage, a dire shortage of the human resources for health in all cadres. Right now as we talk, we actually do not have staffing norms and standards as a policy in the Ministry of Health. Since 2014, between 2018 and 2021, we have not had a document that actually says how many health workers we need at the levels of the facility. Because the staffing norms and standards we had in 2014 that expired in 2018 were never implemented. They said some of them deemed them to be ambitious. We have not even met a 50% of the health workers that we are supposed to be having in our facilities. And that is the biggest challenge that we are having in the health sector, and that is the biggest handle to also achieving universal health coverage. And that is why today we are here to call for the annual employment of health workers, similar to what happens to teachers, to our disciplined forces, to the police. Research has shown that for every one healthcare worker you employ, you create 2.8 jobs, that is 3 jobs. And I know somebody may ask how you do that. When you have people who are in good health, they are not going to spend their money in dialysis, in purchasing medicine for chronic diseases, in treating complications in hospitals, in treating cancer, which takes a lot of money. And that money that they are going to save, they are going to invest, and that investment is going to create employment. And that is why we are saying, at the center of any development of any society lies good health. And you cannot have accessible, quality, affordable services if then you are having health workers who are not adequately staffed. So that is one. Number two, I think we want to say that Mugala muwe lakini haki yake mpe. Our government has tried, our president, we saw the infrastructural projects that were done countrywide during COVID. We saw the vaccination policy and what is ongoing, and it's very commendable. We have also seen the supply of equipment through the MES scheme, which has ensured facilities, even in the hitherto remote areas, are actually able to perform surgeries. and that we give to government, they have done a commendable job, including designating health as one of the pillars of development during this regime, as one of the big four. But though much has been done, so much more remains, because before this regime also, we had that neglect for so long, since independence, of the health sector. And so what we're asking is, through the same goodwill that we are having with this government in improving the health services in the country, that now they can allow a conversation to, number one, get a paradigm shift to preventative and promotive, so that we avoid having people coming to hospitals. We prevent diseases before they occur. We ensure that we adequately staff. And as we go into the election year, because this is election year, and I want to ask Kenyans, because you have a right to the highest attainable standards of health in the Constitution, and especially for your presidential candidates and for the governors, can you please interrogate what they want to do for your health? Because there will be no development if you are not going to be healthy. So anybody talking about development of a country must first talk about how they are going to improve the health status of the population, and then the development is going to follow after that. Lastly, we have a very unfortunate situation in Kirinyaga. In Kirinyaga, the county